Name is Dawn Sheehan, and I'm one of two people along with Sinead Hickey who's involved in the running of the Bride project. It's basically an EIP that has to deliver on biodiversity in a dairying environment, but not just a dairying environment. In the Bride Valley, there's all enterprises, there's equine, sheep, tillage, dairying, beef, etc. So it's a combination of a landscape scale project delivering for all enterprises. Okay, Patrick. So the reasons for forming the Bride project: biodiversity was being lost on farmland at a dramatic rate, and everybody knows that, but it was more especially could be seen on intensive farmland. So it was addressing that issue, and also to create a template for an agri-environment scheme that could be replicated nationally. It's one thing to have a scheme that can be rolled out to 30 or 40 farmers, but if it could be rolled out further afield, it was even more beneficial. So it addresses the issues of biodiversity loss, water quality, and carbon footprint, and also the issue of farmers and farming and the bad press that they had received. So it was trying to raise the public image and the perception of farming. And on the ground, we found that farmers were very willing to get on board. The first night we had 40 seats out, and we had to get another 100 after that. It was a full house. And since then, we've had 65 in the first 2 weeks that applied to get in, and that has now been whittled down to 42. Okay, Patrick. So it's rewarding farmers who are delivering on environmental improvements in their farm. So it's the results-based payments, basically. That you know, if you score well in your habitats, and we score all the habitats on a farm, you're ensuring that the public are getting a return on investment, and we ensured in that. That you're getting a return on the work that you do. So it's paying for effort. So the higher quality the habitats on your farm, the higher payments you get. So it's putting a value on all the land on a farm, not just productive. At the moment, it's just the productive part of your farm has a value. And we all know you know, the term waste ground and non-productive ground. That has a value, whether it's for biodiversity, whether it's for, you know, improving water quality, whether it's for sequestering carbon, and we put a value on all that. Okay, Patrick. So to progress to date, so 2018, biodiversity surveys were carried out on 30 farms. Baseline data was collected on habitats, birds, pollinators, bats, and flora. So we're going to go back in 2023, and hopefully, even though when you're talking about biodiversity, there's always a time lag, but we do hope and we know that there will be improvements in biodiversity, even at this stage. So in 2019, 42 farmers have signed up from all enterprises, 19 dairy farmers, 14 beef, 4 tillage, 4 equine, and 1 sheep farmer. And again, the importance of, as Derek mentioned already, the landscape scale effect of any environmental scheme. There's no point in one farmer doing everything right if neighboring farmers are doing everything wrong. And that's the whole idea of many of the EIPs, is the landscape scale effect of having everyone involved and singing off the same environmental hymn sheet. So each farm was habitat mapped and a BMA percentage. So that's the biodiversity managed area. So that's basically the area that's in habitats. So that was all calculated for each farm. And habitat management plans were drawn up then, so that that they suited the farmer and that they suited the farm. There was no point in putting in specific management plans for tillage farmers in a dairy farm. Okay, Patrick. So the progress in 2020, capital measures were funded up to €2,000 per farm to include creation of pollinator plots, new hedgerows, field margins, ponds, etc. We brought out a habitat management guidelines book developed to provide advice to farmers on how best to manage their habitats. And like Trish mentioned already, that's a huge problem with all farmers, is the lack of knowledge. It's just not there because it was never rolled out to farmers before this, the knowledge that they need. Ecological knowledge, really, and how to manage your habitats and how to manage your farm for environmental care. So we developed and designed score sheets so that every single habitat in the Bride now has a score sheet, and that reflects the ecological quality of each habitat, and it gives an overall farm score, and that's your results-based payment. So it's basically you get a score on your habitat, and it's totted up, and that is your quality score for the farm, and then we put a payment with that. So the payment template, it reflects what the quantity and the quality of habitats on a farm. So you're really paying for the amount of BMA, as I mentioned already, which is the habitats. So we try to get every farm up to 10%. And that's the EU Green Deal and the biodiversity strategy. So we try to get farmers up to 10%. That's your quantity. And then we also pay on the quality of that 10%. And that's your payment.